Good morning, students. Today we will discuss a new topic, repressive policies of Lord Lytton. This point is coming under the growth of nationalism. This repressive policies of Lord Lytton helped to develop the nationalism in India. It helped to develop the agitation among the Indians to fight against the British. Repressive word means, so the word repressive means that anything, any authority is restraining from political freedom or expressing thought and ideas. Means any authority is restraining the people for expressing their thoughts, ideas or desires. Okay, so Lord Lytton made some repressive policies or certain act passed by him which was totally against the Indian interest. So people protested, people became angry, people, and this caused an agitation against him because he passed 3-4 acts and all those acts were against Indian interest. It was only in the interest of the British government. Lord Lytton was an aggressive viceroy, which we will come to know from this act. We will study one by one. We will study in details about the act passed by Lord Lytton. The first one is Vernacular Press Act. Vernacular, we already know what is the meaning of the word vernacular. In the Vernacular Press Act, he mentioned that restriction on the Indian press and printing anything anti-British will be forbidden. Means any in there is a restriction in the Indian press, specifically in Indian press there is a restriction. They are not allowed to print anything anti-British. The Indian press is not allowed to print anything. And this restriction of Vernacular Press Act was only applied in the Indian press. The Indian press specifically are not allowed to print anything anti-British. If they write anything anti-British, then their press house or the Indian press will be closed. Next, after Vernacular Press Act, Arms Act is another act passed by Lord Lytton. This act stated that in order to carry arms, Indian required a license, but European did not require license for the same. Means for carrying gun or any kind of weapon, Indians specially required a license, but same thing carried by European did not require any license. So just imagine, for the Vernacular Press Act, Indian press has all the limitation. For the Arms Act, Indians has all the limitation, but no such limitation for the Europeans or for the British. British can carry guns, British can write anything they want in their press house, but Indians has the limitation and restriction. Indians cannot carry Arms Act without license. So all these restrictions were for the Indians. Now the last point is the Delhi Darbar. Delhi Darbar was held in 1877, the Imperial Darbar. It was for the British Darbar. It was a British Darbar where Queen Victoria was declared as the Empress of India. Queen Victoria, we have already studied in the previous chapter of Revolt of 1857. In this Darbar, she was declared as the Empress of India. That's why this Darbar was held in Delhi with great pomp. All the people of European, all the guests from European came to Delhi, and with great pomp, Queen Victoria was declared as the Empress of India. But in other side of the coin, when this Darbar was taking place, the South India was affected by a famine. They were suffering a lot in South India, but British were least bothered of what is happening in India. They were celebrating the Delhi Darbar. No welfare measures taken by British at that time. So you can see in this picture two sides I am showing. In one side, Delhi Darbar with great pomp, and in other side, the South India affected by a famine. But no welfare measures taken by British to help the South Indian, to give them some food, nothing was done by the British. All these things, all these 3 points and all these differentiations, all these discriminations created agitation among the Indians. This agitation was basically because of the Lord Lytton Acts. All these acts by Lord Lytton made Indians to decide and take a concrete action against the British.